Welcome to My Life in Israel podcast, where I speak the truth with people about finding a solution to the Israeli-Palestinian conflict while combating anti-Semitism, anti-Israel, and anti-Zionist propaganda, and rant about Israeli politics and life in Israel. I also throw in some Judaism to spice things up. What should happen to Gaza the day after we defeat Hamas? Who should control it? These are questions that are being asked now. The Israeli establishment says we need to give the land back to the Palestinians, that we don't want to control it and we don't want to rule over the Palestinians. But I think that's a mistake. Who are we fighting this war for? Are we fighting it for Israel or are we fighting it for the Arabs in Gaza? The pro-Israel side wants to claim that, you know, free Gaza from Hamas. And so if that's the case, then the people in Gaza should want Hamas to be defeated and should support Israel in doing that after they have defeated that. And they should become supporters of Israel after the war. And so this is what needs to happen. We need to figure out how to only let people back who will support Israel's right to exist and not support terror. So that means we cannot allow every single person to come back. There has to be some kind of way to root out the supporters of Hamas and Islamic Jihad and wanting to create another Hamas. So Bibi is right in that we have to control Gaza to enable that to happen for the foreseeable future. We have to have at least security control, and we cannot let the PA in charge. And the U.S. doesn't seem to understand that. The U.S. keeps repeating the same old thing that they've always said, that they want a two-state solution, and they want the PA to be in charge of Gaza, which is a suicide pact allowing the conflict to continue. The U.S. and the U.N. have their own agenda. They want to keep the conflict going. They don't want Israel to win. They are more concerned about protecting civilians who actually don't support Israel. They want Israel to protect them, but they are not concerned about trying to get Hamas defeated and what it takes to do that. So that's the first issue. And again, who are we fighting this war for? There's been images and videos of the IDF planting Israeli flags on the beaches of Gaza, singing Hatikva, and conquering the Hamas parliament, planting Israeli flags. And somehow the IDF seems to not want that. They're reprimanding the soldiers from doing that. I'm like, is it our land or is it not our land? What should we do? Should we be putting Palestinian flags on there? Are we literally just killing ourselves for the people in Gaza to be free from Hamas and not going to have any settlement, Jewish settlement in the land for ourselves? Like, do you call yourself Zionists or not? You can't call yourself a Zionist and do that. We're soldiers are sacrificing themselves for a cause that you won't allow them to fulfill, to not only get rid of Hamas, but to allow a new Gaza without terror. And that means we have to have a presence in Gaza. We have to control Gaza. And not even like we do in the West Bank, because the West Bank is not still sovereign Israeli territory. It should be, but it's not. And so this should allow something different. We should have settlements in Gaza. It is our land. If we don't have settlements in Gaza and proclaim it our land, then it just continues this narrative that the pro-Palestinians say that it's their land and it's not our land. So if we just say, oh, we don't want Gaza, you can have it, then we're just into that narrative agreeing with them that it's not our land, that you can have it because it's yours. So again, we have to have clear goals and a clear purpose. And the purpose is, this is our land and we need to decide who lives there. So make Gaza Jewish again. To all you anti-Israel, pro-Palestinian people who want to bitch and complain about the way Israel fights in Gaza and targets Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihads and targets them specifically, while at the same time Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihad shoot indiscriminately, not targeting the IDF in military positions, and you think that's okay when they indiscriminately shoot rockets and to try and kill as many civilians as possible, which is a war crime, and then turn around and get mad when Israel accidentally injures civilians and possibly children. in defending ourselves and trying to eliminate the people who are responsible for shooting rockets at us. Like, you have, that's such hypocrisy, you have no idea. 20% of the rockets that are shot from Gaza fall back into Gaza and injure and kill their own people. So just because civilians and children are killed doesn't mean it's coming from Israel. 20% of that is coming from Hamas and PIJ themselves. And so the answer to that is to just not shoot rockets. How hard is that to understand? And then no children, civilians will be killed. And then your answer to that is, well, they have to defend themselves. Well, defend themselves against what? They're completely in control of themselves. They fail to recognize that this is jihad, Palestinian Islamic jihad. Their goal is literally in their name. They don't. It doesn't matter. They're not a resistance fighter. They're solely against the Jews, the Jewish people as a whole. And you people in the West who want to support Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihad don't realize that this is a religious war for them. This isn't about land for them. This is a religious war. That's why they only act when it comes to Jerusalem and the Al-Aqsa Mosque. That it's a religious war for them. And so they promote the idea of martyrdom. They want their children to grow up to be martyrs. It's in all the schools. There's plenty of videos showing children themselves saying that they want to be martyrs. And yet I can't show it on here on TikTok because it's against the guidelines. So you can just gaslight people and say it doesn't exist. And I can't show you any proof, but it exists. I'll give you links in the comments if you want to everything. Like, I don't know what you fail to understand. This is not about land for them. And so until you realize that they are not interested in protecting their own civilians, they Israel notifies everybody in Gaza before they bomb a building. They have plenty of time to leave and not get killed. Some choose to stay. And then some people from Hamas and the Palestinian Islamic Jihad tell their people to go up to the roofs to protect themselves with their bodies from the rockets. Like, and then that would create martyrs. They do this on purpose, people. Like, you don't seem to understand that. So they don't care. They don't care about their civilians. They don't care about the children. They don't care about Israeli children or Israeli civilians. They don't care. They're willing to kill anybody in the pursuit of jihad. This is what this is about. And so stop with this ridiculous virtue signaling that you care about there's human rights and war crimes against Israel when they are the ones, Hamas and the PIJ are the ones who are committing war crimes by not protecting their civilians, by targeting civilians in Israel, and then using their own civilians and children as human shields to create martyrs. And so just... So until you realize that,
you need to shut the fuck up.
Thanks for listening to My Life in Israel podcast. Follow me on TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for non-podcast videos. If you enjoyed the podcast, like, share, comment, and follow me on Spotify and other podcast apps so you never miss another episode. Support my work and support Israel by making a one-time or monthly donation or become a subscriber to get access to exclusive content. The links are in my profile and description. And stay tuned because I have a lot more to say. Am Israel High.